Wenn ich jetzt sterben würde, was würdest du machen?
The Berlin-set film Run Lola Run 1998 is a German crime drama thriller that honestly consisted mostly of running. It almost felt like she chose not to drive or hitch a ride. Going into this movie, it's kind of expected from the movie titled Run Lola Run that is very much focused on, well, Lola running. The synopsis of the movie goes like this. Lola, played by Franca Pontene, receives a phone call from her criminal boyfriend Manny, played by Moritz Bleibtreu, who is calling from a random phone booth about how he lost 100,000 Deutschmarks on a subway car. In the urgent time-limiting phone call, he gives Lola 20 minutes to come up with a replacement of the money and a solution to deliver it to him. This then causes Lola to frantically sprint all over the city to beg money out of her father, played by Hubert Knopp, who just so happens to be a bank manager, and attempts to get it to Manny just in time to save her boyfriend's life and their romance. If the money is not within his possessions, it leaves Manny a dead man. Run Lola Run uses flashback scenes to help align and connect missing pieces of the story together. It also introduces the audience to an aspect of digital animation and also leaves the viewers with a feeling of repetition and a constant time loop. All of these ideas and storylines comes from the brain of a German director, writer, producer, and composer, Tom Teichwa, who was born in Wuppertal, Germany in 1965. Often, a narrative of a film uses something known as the three-act structure. So what is the three-act structure? It is a narrative model that divides the story into, well, three parts. Act 1, known as the beginning, which is the setup of the movie. Act 2, the middle, is often the confrontation scene. And Act 3 is the ending. It is where a peace or resolution takes place. However, in Run Lola Run, it can be seen that it does not technically follow the common three-act structure to a T. In fact, it manipulates the way in which the story is structured. Instead, it follows a structure consisting of an equilibrium, Act 1, or normality, then follows by enigma, Act 2, which is an event or action in which disrupts normality in the lives of the characters, then followed by the middle, Act 3, section or a disequilibrium, which slowly moves the story back to a sense of normality, and then it ends in Act 4, when the equilibrium in Act 1 is resolved through the enigma, which is Act 2. The enigma in the case of the structure is the money and how Lola manages to deliver it on time. Starting with the opening of the film, it can be seen that the film starts with a sense of slight normalcy in the home of Lola, which is then followed by a phone call from her boyfriend Manny. But in this particular scene, it doesn't give the audience a sense of understanding on as to why this phone call took place, but essentially starts building pieces of a puzzle that leads up to the enigma, which is Act 2. The use of black and white and cartoons to differentiate current life and flashback points allow the users to understand the storyline much better. The reason for what makes Run Lola Run's narrative different from other movies is based on Tom Teichwa's artistic genius of allowing three separate narratives to depict the cause and effect and outcome of each event through the use of animation and the sequence of Lola running down the stairs with slight alterations in every version. It can be seen here that Tom Teichwa plays around with the concept of time, as there are sections of a flashback and flash forward, making audiences gripped. All of these three separate alternative narratives can be seen later in the film. It can also be seen that certain repetition and introduction in the three alternative narratives is what makes Run Lola Run bend the traditional film narrative. To summarize the narrative structure of Run Lola Run, it begins firstly with a slight beginning, or equilibrium, which sorts of sets the audience in a sense of normalcy. It can be seen the use of flashback helps piece together crucial information in the narrative. The sense of normalcy is cut short after the beginning phone call and dives into the enigma, which brings the audience into the very issue that Lola needs to get and replace the misplaced 100,000 German mark and also to save her boyfriend. When progressing into the narrative, the way in which the enigma was solved could be seen in the three separate alternatives, consisting of a flashback and flash forward. But the ending, however, could be seen in the three alternatives, but no final one was concluded. With that, it concludes the narrative of the whole film. My thoughts and opinions on this film would firstly be that this film is definitely a very interesting film to watch, understand and analyze, and it is a very unique version of narration and storytelling. It almost feels like a choose your adventure storybook, where the audience was able to choose or imagine the outcome of each event. Overall, this film is definitely a 10 out of 10, and it's definitely worth recommending to friends and family and to the people who are watching this video. You guys should really go check it out.